Hello, Liverpool. Hello. Hello. Just like to apologise to everyone before I start, because I've got a terrible hangover. I didn't go out last night. I've just got this terrible... Just go away. Yeah, hi, I'm Tony Carlo. I've been in stand-up comedy now for 7 years. Yeah, it's great. Yeah, I'm also a football coach. I actually am. I think I'm a good football coach. I like teaching the kids life lessons as well as football. I think I'm a good coach, but we're getting beat 15 at half time last week. And I was fucking fuming on the lads. I was like, you fucking dickheads, like that. And a lad had come off the other team and he went, ah, he's a shit, right? So I buttered him, right? Two more lads come over. And I drop kicked them both. And three more come over. And I got one of them in an armbar to do mixed martial arts in my spare time. And he was tapping. And he was going, ah, get off me. And I was like, no. And he was like, please. I was like, no. Wanted to hit me, but it didn't hurt. Four more come over, and I've done a roundhouse kick like this. But like, I'd show you, but my jeans are quite tight tonight. And five more come over. Yeah, I'm trying to get the right order, I don't want to lie to you. Yeah, five more come over. I knocked all them out, listen, if you don't want a boy, is like, but it was like 15 bodies all around me, right? Yeah, I've been bad in the Rates League now. Yeah, it's good. It's a nice club, this, isn't it? It's really nice, isn't it? It's very nice, yeah. I done a gig similar to this last weekend, Landud. No, give me a cheer if you've been to Landud now before. Yeah. I walked out and said, hello, Landud, no. And I just didn't get nothing. And a fella stood up from the back and said, excuse me, mate, it's not Landud, no, it's Clandud, no. I said, all right, mate, fucking hell. I said, whereabouts are you from, mate? I said, Cliverpool, now fuck off. I've got a girlfriend now, give me a cheer. Yeah. Yes. She doesn't know it, yeah? Do you? I'm joking. I met her in the gym, and I was on one treadmill. Debbie, she was on the other treadmill. Mine wasn't going, I was just standing on the treadmill. I looked at her and said, hiya. She looked at me and she said, hiya. I said, do you want to have fun? She went, no. And I said, but I've got the F, and the N, all I need is you. Wafting a fart then, mate. I asked her to go on a date with me. She agreed to go on a date with me. I was really nervous with taking on a date because I hadn't been on many dates before. Been on one, that was with my dad. He's in prison now. I was thinking about some fancy restaurants I could take her in Liverpool, like Circo, Living Rooms. So we went to the 80s. I just know it's 2 meals for the tenner, isn't it? So we spent 180 quid. God. The date went well, been together for 3 years now, so everything's great. But Debbie's a dickhead, right, because she likes cats. Give me a cheer if you like cats. Give me a cheer if you don't like cats. Don't like cats, not horrible. But she went on holiday, and she asked me to mind the cat for a while. She went on holiday, and I held her to my mum, and I said, yeah, that's fine. So she went on holiday, and she was away for a few days. She rang me, and she went, hiya, love. And I said, hiya, obviously. She said, so how's the cat? I said, it's dead. She started crying. Is it really dead? I said, yeah, it's dead. She said, fucking hell, Tony, you could explain how it died, like it climbed up on a roof and died peacefully. I said, no, you dickhead, it's dead. She started crying again. She said, how's my mum? I said, well, she climbed up on the roof. We're doing stand-up comedy. You tend to go out and drink a lot because I'm always on the air. My favourite pub is around the corner. You know Woody's bar, karaoke bar. Yeah, I love it there. I love going there after a gig and have a little sing and that, and a little bevy, whatever. Like, but there's this lad in there. There's this gay lad in there. And he sells shots. I know he's gay because when I kissed him, he closed his eyes. Sells these Jaeger bombs on the stage, right? And he comes up to me, my mate, and he's like, do you want to buy a Jaeger bomb? And I'm like, no, thanks, mate. And he's like, oh, come on, baby, just buy a Jaeger bomb, they're only £1. I said, no, mate, I'm all right, thanks. So he goes away and he comes back and he puts the tray down and he looks at me, he's like, contact with me. And he's like, do you want to buy a Jaeger bomb? I said, I think I'll pass, mate. And he's going, come on, baby, just buy a Jaeger bomb. Listen, mate, do us a favour, right? I don't want to buy a Jaeger bomb, so go away, right? So he goes away and he comes back again, right? And he gets really, really close and personal to me, and he's like, hey, big boy, do you want to buy a Jaeger bomb? I said, right, do me a favour now, mate, fuck off, I don't want to buy a Jaeger bomb. He goes, come on, just buy a Jaeger bomb. I said, fuck off, I don't want to buy a Jaeger bomb. He goes, come on, just buy a Jaeger bomb. I said, I'll have two, please. I ask a question. This question a lot of gigs. So I need to ask one of yous. I'll ask you. Hiya, love. Yeah, not bad. What's your name? Grace. I'm Tony. I think you already know that. said my name before. What's your biggest fear, if you don't mind me asking, in life?
Spiders.
No, to be honest, I've asked this a lot of times, and a lot of people have said spiders. People say like spiders. Heights, snakes, people said me before. It's fine, like, it's not that's all it needs to know, because obviously I know that you've come here for the comedy club and all that, and you know, you've had a great act on and whatever, and you've all had a great night and a good laugh, but I'd like to just tone it down a little bit and just get a little bit serious, because basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you like a bonus. I want you to all first step to think of all your biggest fear, right? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell you my biggest fear. When you leave out of the room, you won't be scared of your biggest fear anymore, right? Is that all right? Yeah? Is everyone okay with that, yeah? Right, so the first thing you need to do, you need to all think of your biggest fear, okay? Right. I didn't hear that. What was it? You said life. Wow. Have you just said your biggest fear is life? Oh, his wife. I thought you said life. I'm gonna say, fucking hell, mate, it's a bit dark. We don't fucking watch you for the next 24 hours. Who said his wife? Wow, his wife. She's not gonna be that bad.
You know what, though?
Yeah.
Right, eighth anniversary sign as well.
He's, fucking hell, you're horrible, you, aren't you? You brought your beard to a comedy club anniversary and said your biggest fear is your wife. Come here, love. I'll look after you, love. You come to ours. Get to ours. So do you want to buy a fucking Jaeger one? Right, seriously now, hey, come on, now, it's fucking really upset me when I think about my biggest fear. Can you all think of your biggest fear, right? Jesus. Right, basically, my biggest fear in life is getting kidnapped and being made into a sex slave, right? Oh, seriously, please, try not to laugh, because it's fucking really shakes me up, right? It really does. Right. I need you to all picture it, right, as I tell the story. Right, listen up. I've just finished a gig of Hot Water Comedy, and I'm standing outside with a cigarette and minding my own business, right? Next minute, this van pulls up, right? Is everyone picturing it? Yeah? This van pulls up. It's got to be a big van, right? Now listen, this fella jumps out the van, right? Jumps out the van, he goes, "Get in the van!" And I'm like, "No." And he's like, "Please." And I'm like, "All right." So... So we get into this van, right? And he shuts the door, slams the door, and I'm sitting there, and it's pitch black, I'm scared, I'm shaking. And the van speeds off, right? And I'm in this back of the van for about 4 or 5 hours, absolutely petrified, and it pulls up, and the doors slide open, right? And the fellow jumps out the van, and he goes, "Get out the van!" And I'm like, "No." And he's like, "Please." And I go, "All right, so we get out the van." He marches me down to the cellar, right? In this, like, moody cottage in South Wales. Marches me down to the cellar. And he takes me right down. He ties me up like this. Is everyone still pitching it? Yeah. He ties me up like this. And he pulls me pants down, right? He lets me leave my top on because I'm self-conscious about my tits. And he's starting to have a go, yeah? He's having a fucking good go, right? And I'm like, "Ah, get off me!" And he's like, "No." And I'm like, "Please." And he just comes over and whispers in me, "Should have bought that Jaeger bomb." I've been Tony Carroll. Thank you very much. Have a good night.